approximately 50 years ago, under the direction of President Harry Truman and in the interest of national security, a group of 12 top military scientific personnel were established. This group's primary objective was to desensitize us to the truth and to suppress the material evidence that our planet is being visited by a group of extraterrestrial biological entities called the Greys.
Tune in to Channel Zero. 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 Tune in to Channel Zero.
Yo, sometimes the road to the truth is so elusive, it's confusing, and reality becomes illusion. If I showed the masses where we was at and where we was going, I'd shatter the social balance of the world as we know it. I'm talking about the grand deception of 1947, when our souls were sold to the heavens for technologically advanced weapons, crystal enhanced brain implants and mind control methods. MJ-12 is not majestic, and the focal point of our problems on this planet are not domestic. You can accept it or be stupid and be a skeptic. I fail to recognize the secret society's death. 97% of our presidents were masons, responsible for laundering trillions of dollars from the nation for the construction of underground military installations, abductions and cattle mutilations, experiments on human patients to take place in several subterranean bases, 150 stories below a basement, with knowledge of genetic information. You need to fear science, not Satan, cause through the manipulation of certain biological agents, they create strange creations, top secret special operations, low frequency sounds and lasers. People like Carl Sagan that didn't believe in the Drake equation. We're trying to keep Western civilization on a need-to-know basis. Well, you need to know that this is a game, and we're being portrayed and played in the worst way.
Tune in to Channel Zero. 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 Tune in to Channel Zero.
From Genesis 1:26 says, let us make man in our image under our likeness. First of all, who's they? You see, if God was truly a single entity, that's not what he would say. We as the Elohim, gods and goddesses, possess a marvelously monstrous subconscious. Life forms to speak in very high-pitched sounds and squeaks, short staccato clicks and beeps, a highly advanced form of speech. Even though to us it seems like they only chatter in their teeth, they used to swim deep in the oceans beneath, till their fins transformed into limbs and they started to creep. Then they evolved into mammals with feet and walked right from the shorelines onto the beach. They use gravity, cause it's actually the only force around that could slow time and the speed of light down. The energy grid network opened the gateway from Earth to any point in the universe. Living organisms in various geomagnetic gravitational anomaly areas. Space expedition teams in the lunar regions reported seeing scissor pyramids and tetrahedrons. Liquid filled shoes is what they use to walk across the moon without leaving a clue of where they've been for the past 23 billion years. Before life on the surface even appeared, I hope you become aware what I'm spitting in your ear was intended to stimulate your left brain's hemisphere. I know it sounds weird, all these motherfucking answers and questions to the grand deception.
Tune in to Channel Zero. 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 Tune in to Channel Zero.
Tune in to Channel Zero. Tune in to Channel Zero.